Select your character. Ben Shishigami, Makoto Nanaya.
Going on this whole time that I've been commentating to, like, air. Okay, now I'm in, good match before. Oh, gosh, I have some good comments, too. Nice reversal by Gilgamesh. Anyway, what's up, guys? Welcome to the my first BBCPEX tournament that I'm hosting. I participated before, but this is the OD that could be game. Oh, not quite. Oh, yep, it's game. I was here the whole time and I didn't have my commentary yet because I'm stupid like that.
Rebel 3, action!
Just getting the speed out. And we're so proud of Gilgamesh being pulled this out because I know someone who died is a really well respected, good player. But that mix-up might be... Oh, he baited the first. That's game for that one. Match one goes to someone who died.
なるほどな。そうだ。拙者の弟子4号になってみる気はござらぬか?いや、決してやましい気持ちがあるわけではござらんよ。
Okay, I have no idea how to make it so the lobby cannot hear me on this one. I should buy a better mic. It's not the okay, if someone can explain to me how I make it so that I have a lot of static. Zach, do me a favor and turn my fan off, please. I have a lot of static. Okay, my fan's off now. Make a PS4 party. Okay, I'll do that. Okay, can you guys still hear me?
Rebel One, action!
Can everyone who is watching the Twitch stream hear me now? Oh, you can. Cool. That should be fine for the people now. Thank you for the tip! I had no idea how that works. Almost going for a perfect with someone who died, but gets the random hit. Cross up. Those cross ups seem to be getting good in it quite a bit.
Rebel 2, action!
Okay, to anybody who didn't get there, who's not in the tournament in Frosty War, you have got to remember to check in. I didn't do that in my last tournament, it was a shit show. So I apologize if you didn't check in. But you gotta... We had 19 since we went down to 13. Everybody, have confidence in Ryu. Oh, well, he put up a really good effort. Everybody give a little congratulations to Ryu, because that is just a difficult opponent. That might be our tournament winner right there in the form of someone who died. Okay, so score of 2-0, that sends Ryu to losers. Or Gilgamesh, if you guys don't know him. And remember, losers matches take place off-stream. I can do all the winners, but I want, until we get down to just losers, I want all of the matches and losers to be off-stream. Ultra Force and Fame. I know Fame is in here. Ultra Force, you need to get in here. Anybody know where Ultra Force is? To Ethrol, I already told you, your match must take place on the stream. I said that all winners would be streamed, so I'm not counting that match. Why do you mean you submitted your score?
Noel Vermillion.
No. Is Jay She BB? Jay She BB? Is this Ultra Force? I don't know, Ultra Force is... Oh, that's you. Okay, it is you. Okay, that is Ultra. So we have Ragna versus Noelle. I don't think I fought... I think I may have fought Fame before. I have never fought Ultra Force. I'll call him Ultra. For anybody who's curious, JCBB goes by Ultra Force. Within my bracket and on the tournament chat. So that's probably what I'll be referring to him as, is Ultra. Not starting out particularly well for him. Fame getting that corner carry for that wicked damage that Ragnar has from this version. Gets reset. Oh, doesn't block on wake up at all, which is kind of proving to be his undoing. Definitely needs to learn some patience. Is it Fib? I don't know.
Rebel TV. Action.
Ooh, it looks like they're getting a little desperate. Gotta block on that wake up. Proving to be his undoing to a degree. Not to a degree, here I get it. Getting that corner carry. Trying way too hard to mash out of the pressure. Fame taking advantage of that. And that makes 1-0 for right now. Ultra needing to block. If you're a friend of Ultra's, tell him block.
Please select your character. Ragnar the Blood Edge. Noel Vermillion.
Now in this matchup, Noelle is definitely outraged. I can imagine the Fortu's game is very difficult for her. However, Ragna's health isn't terrific and she does a shit ton of damage. So if she manages to get on him, she should be okay.
Fair and square.
The Wheel of Fate is turning. Rebel 1, action!
Ooh. Always starting off with that overdrive confirm. The nice damage, pushing him into the corner. Again, the counter hit on the wake up. Gets hit by the JC overhead mix up. Oh, that hurt. Again. Will he block on his wake up this time? Nope. This Dolph managed to get out of the corner somehow. Really missed time and poorly spaced gunshot there though.
Ragnar wins! Rebel 2! Action!
Ooh, that last spike kinda killed that combo. So we have to achieve to it that play. Ultra not seeming to know his combos particularly well. Ooh, they tried to JCB. Is that just JD? Yeah, it's a command. I think it's JD, yes. Phase out the JD. Ultra attempting to zone Fame out here. Fame playing very patient. Actually, not sure why he's not charging in at all. I was just waiting for that. Kinda feels like he's playing with him a bit. Come on, Fame! Don't be a dick! Anybody else calling Astral set up here by Fame? Kinda waiting. Oh, come on, that's... For future reference, guys, that's kinda douchey. Aww. I mean, you're free to do what you want, but that was a little douchey. Come on, Fame. Okay, I need Joshua VV and Lord Dustmas. Joshua VV, Lord Dustmas. Joshua VV, if you're watching the stream, you're up. He means Jeremy. Anybody know who Lord Dustmas is? Because his... In the future, guys, it'd be so much easier if you signed it... If you use your child name and your PSN name is one and the same. I'm assuming
please
that's him.
Please select your character.
Oh, Big Daddy Dusty-ish. Okay, that makes sense. I'm gonna call him Dusty. Let's make things simple.
Kazuma.
So Joshua, going with Hazma, his usual name, I have played him for years.
Relius Clover.
I feel like I fought Dusty before and I'm just not remembering. It's fully possible. And I would just like to point out, regardless of anybody's performance in the tournament, I'm just happy they came out. It's a great experience for anybody, especially people who want to get offline tournaments. This can help kind of settle your nerves in an online environment before you try offline, which is inevitably harder 9 times out of 10. Although, skill can be varied.
The Wheel of Fate is turning! Rebel 1, action!
Starting off with an air grab. No, he's trying to jump back. It's kind of cut off steam tourneys. If you're asking if I will ever do a steam tourney, no. I do not have this on. Oh, soon. Okay, that's what we're trying to do. Nope, I'm sorry, I don't have this on steam. Grab City! That's PPEX damage, I never thought Hazma would be coming for it. He did drop the combo. That was a pretty fatal drop on his part. Going for the setup, but oh boy, doesn't seem to work out. Oh, but tries to burst out. Will this be a really miraculous comeback? Nope, gets hit by the 2A.
Rebel 2!
Is he gonna dust him? No, well, pun intended. Yep, that's it. Perfect. 0-1. Dusty's favor. And again, people, all winners' matches are on the stream. Losers will be played off stream.
Please select your character. Relius Clover.
Now, I know Joshua can adapt rather well, so we'll see how this one goes. You want a pillow? Yeah. Okay. Okay, there. Yeah.
Ragnar the Bloodedge!
I'm gonna do it.
No, I'm sorry to all the Steam players. I don't have it on Steam. I don't plan... Or Steam. I don't plan to get it on Steam.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1. Action.
Oh. Now, I know that's what's planning on making humans either Valius, Avial, or even Dualman sort of thing. Perhaps to work out better for him with Ragnar's Fricky games. But yeah, see, not when he lives in momentum burst out. I could start doing it. Legal stages, I don't really have any rules on stages. Most people should be, at this point, considering how long the stage has, that the game has been out. Everybody knows what the tournament, what the online standards are for these 5v3 stages. Coffee environment is what everyone's been picking, and that is one of the best, so this works out just fine. Gotta having a bit of a hard time trying to get used to things. Dusty, is this going to be a second perfect? Are we seeing Mullen? Not first out does not want to get perfect hit. He is the first. Got Mullen, unfortunately. Good games to both, nonetheless. So that's 2-0 Dusty. I need chaotic games and mecha. Who is... What is chaotic... Chaotic games is chaotic games on here, I assume. So Mecha knows he's up. We just need to get chaotic games in here. There's Mecha. Chaotic Games, where be you? You hidden at the bottom here? And I don't know why that thing comes up when you're not even... Anybody know the logic behind why the entry comes up even when you have yourself on autopass? Seems kind of pointless to me. Do I feel like sitting with any of you? Nah. Go to the bed. I can't sit with you. Having a bit of trouble here with finding the room, but that's okay. Remember everyone, if you have a match in Losers, Ultra, Joshua, you can have that match now if you want. And we're starting
Please
Chaotic Games versus... Chaotic Games versus Mecha. I'll call it Mecha and Chaotic. I should participate sometime. Oh, on my own turn. I play the game a lot. If you ever want to get in touch with me and you have it on PSN, I am more than willing to play with you. You just gotta send me an at on Discord. Or you can always send me a friend request on PSN. Just let me know it's you and say why you sent it. I don't accept randoms. So, Jin versus Azrael.
The wheel of fate is turning.
Rebel Jin versus Azrael. I feel so special. You're like half paying attention to your work to watch my stream. I appreciate it. Mecha playing rather cautious, but gets hit anyway. That Azrael damage gets the weak point. Using that incredibly good back dash of Azrael to bait out, make Mecha whip. Oh, and the purple throw. Oh, that'd be some Disney bit. 6.1k with purple throw.
Rebel 2.
First out, does not want to be put in the corner. This is the guard point. Hit by the overhead. Another purple throw. Oh man. That is definitely a net play thing to use purple throws and combos. Alright, well, game one goes to Chaotic. Game number two. Not sure why this shock focuses on character. You can call it deck, or you can call it an online tactic. You generally do not see that in offline matches. Anybody who's watched streams, attended tournaments, offline. This is not really a thing that happens, purple throwing mid-combo. Not like this.
Sector 7's wild beast. The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1.
So kind of hoping for Mecha to pull it out here. See, I won't be that unbiased commentator. I'm a bitch like that, so I'm gonna fully show who I know I'm rooting for here. How do you catch? Oh my. Mecha also a much better dodge attempt, has him in the corner of the Chaotic boat, bursting out. JTC, nice combo. Bring him right back into the corner he bursted out of. This is a disrespect. Something the Mecha can play on, using more meaty attacks. And he doesn't have a DP yet. Trying to zone him out a little bit, probably a good idea. Definitely, if you have the ability to stay away from Azrael, it's going to be the better idea to do so. Got that weak point. Ooh, is he going to burst out? Burst, Mecha, burst! There we go. Smart burst. Oops. And he's being very careful of the Growler projectile. Nice.
Rebel 2, action!
Ooh, DP start, not good, gets baited out, gets back to the corner early on. Reset. That's gonna hurt a fucking lot. That's gonna be over 5k, I believe. Oh, not quite. I'm a little lost, that's it though. Ooh, and a perfect but Chaotic. Mecha probably needs to be a tad more careful for his bounce start.
Oh.
check. Kind of very carefully gone about using things like JCD, Ice Sword, all that good stuff. Much more careful on defense this time. Oh, the back roll, that's not a good idea. Forward to the right, do not roll in the corner. Generally asking to get hit. And the super rush finish that. 0-2 chaotic.
Azrael, win!
Again, you definitely want a neutral tech when you're in the corner. Alright, I need Stingray. And I need Ephrel. If you are not, again, if you are not playing, put yourself on autopass or leave. Mecha, chaotic. Leave or autopass. They need to auto pass. There we go. So we are starting it out Stingray versus Ethereal. Now Stingray was in my Guilty Gear tournament. Did a very good job. Got rather far. I believe he took 5th. I know he uses Axe on this, and I'm very it's very interesting that he's using Bullet.
Yuki Terumi.
Whoever said you're gonna avoid Terumi, sorry. Does not even need it for her damage, which is probably the bigger difference between the two. That purple throw, though, popular tonight during the first matchup. Bullet has my speed up after a mashing out of the Oki. There goes the Sammy Springtrap, but matches up at just the right time. Stingray putting him in the corner. Face out the reversal. No punish, though. Although I don't know if full experience if that's possible. The A's him off. Stingray kinda having a bit of a hard time with Tanner's offense here. Smash out the right time twice now, but as a whole seems to be having some difficulty. Oh, gets hit by the 2A on his wake-up. Does block that frame trap, though. Now that is the sort of thing that might end up being game, but nope, gets the reversal. Thought he'd get him in the corner and do something with it, but unfortunately that didn't get anywhere. That 6A, gray anti-air, definitely be wary of it when you're fighting Jeremy. Gonna be able to keep him in the corner this time? Decent-ish damage for, you know, a non-heat-up bullet. Oh, gets pushed out with barrier, so the overhead does not land. Stingray needing the blast. Burst out. Face to reverse, but still no punish. Instead gets knocked out. F3T. Oh, drops the combo. Good DP. Alright. Definitely an interesting match. Good combo drops on both. There's some combo drops on both sides. Pressure drops punish Nuku. That reversal. Up jumps out of the way of that, which is hard to do actually, generally crouching under that move. That'll be damage if he doesn't drop it. Oh, uses the SMP. Not good. You can use it in the next game, but not right now. That should be it with the meter. No, drops the combo again. Stingray dropping left and right. Steve Ezra going for some nice damage. Drops his combo as well, though. That could be a fatal drop on his part. Indeed it was. 0-1 Stingray. Am I getting a lot of swearing in here because... Rainbow Nick, are you causing problems? Ooh, doesn't get the combo off there. Chooses to go for heat up instead. So I believe that was an intentional job to get the heat up. Another drop in the reversal during that recovery. Does do the 60 conversion, which is nice. That should be it, yep. Have some good time smashing out, but can't be rather inconsistent like this. Oh, overhead barrier is out. That won't work. Get hit by the command grab. We'll just come. Oh, buddy, what have you used meteor combo? Now, if he doesn't drop this, no, another drop. Either that or is it an attempt at a pressure reset? Well, in any case, that takes 0-2 Stingray. Knocking Ephro into losers. So, I need Kuma King and someone who died. the Chan virus. Ah, oh, you're awful. Okay, someone who died is still in here. We need to get Kuma King in. Alternate and Joshua, if you finish your match, you should be able to, report your own. And, I think Fame is in the Twitch chat, so, if somebody could type out that boop is the password. I know he's here, he checked in, I've been communicating with him. He should be here somewhere. Boop. Please say that's the password, otherwise it looks like a random boop. Kuma. No. Fame is not the one who's up. It's Kuma King. Wrong person. Fame is already in here. I'll give him a few more minutes, because I know he's there. He just needs to be a little more active. Kuma King. What's he doing? I'm gonna have to DQ him soon. I'll give him 2 more minutes. Can't hold it up too long. I don't know who Kuma King uses. He was in my Guilty Gear tournament. I didn't see his match on there because there were way too many options for me to stream them all. So I can't even make a correlation between who he made in Guilty Gear and who he might main in here. He responded on Discord. Oh, you're there? Okay, well, you guys are gonna start your match. Oh, wait. I knew he was here, I figured he'd show. Thank you to everybody who watched my Guilty Gear tournament last time and reminded me to do check-ins. This is definitely going smoother for it. Alrighty, here we go. Someone who died versus Kuma King.
Please select your character.
Someone who died, possibly sticking with. Nope, I have no idea what it's going to use.
Ben Shishigami.
Sticking with Ben.
Thank you.
Another Dune player. I can't see gifts on the PS4 version. Janet Twinnett. I have a first base! Overhead, but cannot convert that without needle. Simply works in the pressure reset. Full drag into the point. Ooh, that lag spike. She got like a bit of a combo. Ooh, doesn't seem like her connection is the greatest in the world. I think it's causing some drops. Kuma not going to know how to handle his offense.
Rebel 2! Action!
Ugh. Lag does not look terrific between these two. Ooh. Guard points at exactly the right time for that move. Overhead combo, no, burst out! The command grab super gets him. 1-0 pretty convincingly from someone who died.
Please select your character.
Yeah, it looks really laggy. Kuma though. I do archive video. I just started with this. This will be my first archive, actually, because I didn't do it for my last one. I didn't realize how to do it, really. So. Kuma, if you have the stream going while you're playing, that's not going to help. So do pause the stream. Or exit the window, something like that.
Rebel 1, action!
Get the other bit of time. Oh wait, no, you just had your match, so you're done. Well, thanks for your participation, Ultra. Appreciated. I appreciate everyone who participates in watching. Pushing into the corner. But that 4.2k is difficult to come back from. Match is having a nice time. Oh, good DP. Oh, but the throw from full corner carry does a 3C to make sure he stays there. And brain trap.
Rebel 2, action!
Doesn't get the combo, I don't know if that's the lag speaking. Oh, misses the grab. Some of the guys jumping out at a great time. That probably needs to be going for it. Setting up bumpers. Always be careful of things that never throw an attack. Oh, is he teabagging? I would hope not. Oh, no, fatal. But the bumper is... I need to very quickly get up there. The Meg's already fast, so I think that is it, though. Always be, you've got to be wary of things neutral. Especially when he has bumper set up. Fate to burst. That'll probably be... Oh, nope, misses the combo. But that was it anyway. 2-0, someone who died. Alright, Fame and Dusty, you're the match that you've been waiting for. Alright, and Kuma King and Ethereal, if you want to take your match off stream and losers, go ahead. Chantelay, is everything going to be blamed on Chan here? There we go. Now these two seem to know each other very well, so I'm interested to see who this plays, how this plays out.
Please select your
You're gonna blame everything on Chan Rebellion. Okay, poor Chan. He's at work. He can't even defend himself.
Yuki Terumi. Relius Clover.
A little too well. Yes, I am very excited for this one. At your Junes is how I'd pronounce your name. Same pick Teremy. So if that's his main, he must be really serious. And Afro Kuma, remember to report your scores in challenge.
The Wheel of Fate is turning. Rebel 1.
It might still be Grand Finals. You never know if one of them battles back and loses. It could be Grand Finals all over again. Although remember that when Grand Finals hits, whoever shoots and loses has to win 2 sets of best of 3 matches. I'm gonna take a guess and say, Fame is not the type to drop your standards. Fame being very careful with all of the issues. Oh, great conversion there. Gets him fully to the corner. Base to reversal. Oh, gets the kind of drop back combo. Nice rapid. Oh, go for the unblockable setup, but he was a late tech and did not hit. Nice crap trigger to get through the guard. Oh, good pick though. Will it be a full corner convert or will it be... Dang, this guy seems terrific with those converts on big A. Being careful not to match out with Aurelius pressure, even when he is not using his ultimate, waiting for the chance that he might be using it. Very, very smart move on Fame's part. Great corner carry combo there. Doesn't get the bob, now he gets moved fully in the corner. That's got to be it for that. I think. Will that be enough to kill? Yes, it is. 1-0, Fame. Loop it to loop. Score 1-0, but who knows, Dusty could pull that off. Dusty has the mind game.
Please select your character.
Got Fame to block the smart move on Fame's part even without Ugress being present. Well, present on screen at least. I guess she's always the present unless she's completely on cooldown. Unless the Ignis Gauge is down. And yes, he is terrific at those 6A IAD loops. Seems to get better corner carry than the 6A 2D loops. Oh, yep. They're even using the same color. Does that mean they're friends?
The Wheel of Fate is turning! Rebel 1, action!
What epic music to go with this? Oh gosh, I should use the term epic. Nope, I had to play in Japanese because I have the Japanese version, so I don't actually have the opportunity to set the Japanese version. And I don't double buy versions, so I'm just gonna get the Japanese version and call it a day. Yep, I got the info. Oh, good back deck on that 2A, shifting the momentum into a 2 solo. Gets him fully in the corner, dealing with that wicked early pressure. Crush figure to get through the defenses, and that's the round.
Rebel 2, action!
Dusty starting the round up strong. Doesn't go for the unblockable setup, even with that move. Goes for the OD. Does that mean up? Nope. Seems to have been a combo up. Nice grapper. Getting Ignis back full. Just laying on the pressure. Making Fame just deal with it. Face the burst and a perfect for the round win on Dusty's part. 1-1.
Please select your character. Aurelius.
Rooting for Jeremy. I'm gonna root for Aurelius. Sabaha. Snowbally. don't often hear that term. Let's everybody rooting for Fame. I'm gonna be rooting for Dusty. Okay, though, besides who you're rooting for, everybody, Twitch chat, place your bets. Who do you think is going to win between these two friends who obviously know each other's playstyles very well? Dusty not letting Fame jump out. Good ideas on Fame's part to try to change the meter. Change the box again. Oh, nice rabbit for the full corner carry combo. And that's gonna hurt. Yeah, 3.5 kills. Alright, I'll try to get a hold of Kuma. First thing out. get the Ignis gauge back, and Zane did not, was unfortunately not able to do a whole lot with that. And on that match point, Dusty. I could be right here, bitches. By the way, you guys, it is pretty hot in my room. I know some of you who live in the south would probably make fun of me for thinking this is hot, but I am suffering for you. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, so kind. Just turn my fan on. If there's too much dash, let me know and I'll turn it back off, but it is hot. Yes, I find the 80s to be hot, but I live in New York. If things can keep him in this corner, that should definitely be easy. Without him, he would end up being great. Oh, so good! Hype! If I can figure out a way to get it from my archives to YouTube, I'm definitely gonna want this match there. I know, I knew somebody was gonna say something. I live in New York, fuck off, I don't know that. I don't have to deal with 100 some odd degree heat. You can all come back to me in the winter when I'm dealing with below zero. I'm not used to heat up here. It's been a really hot summer for us. In the 90s, apparently. But back to the map. Same barriering him out a little more than the other. During the other stream. It's not why I'm kind of feeling like they want to get crest triggered. Oh, nice reversal there to go through Ignis. Up, drive, but same with really good move of weaving around the Ignis attack. That rabbit might just do it. Up, we got the loop, and that'll be it. Or at least it should be. Yep. Oh, that was a really hype match. Go! Good job on Fame 2-1, our first 2-1 of the night. Really great match, you two. Okay, I need Chaotic in here again. Against my good friend, Soaring Zero. Who I know is here. So be Chaotic versus Zero. Zero is a Tsubaki player who you do not get to see much, and he's a pretty solid one. So anybody who likes to see Tsubaki, especially considering she's so rare, now is your chance. He is a character loyalist, has been with Tsubaki since CS1. So, he be an OG Tsubaki player. Of course, I'm gonna be rooting for him. So, definitely gonna be rooting for Tsubaki. Ah, really? You're gonna say Io to Tsubaki? When do you see her? What happened to Chaotic? Did he just lag out? He did lag out. Chaotic, you need to come back. Yes. Yeah, like having some issues. A lot of Tsubaki players seem to be lately. Seems to be the trend. I'm assuming character love. I'm gonna go with character love on that one, since that makes the most sense. Although, you think like, the character is a little different. But, or you have a thing for redheads, I don't know. I'm not passing judgment much. Alrighty. So we have Soaring Zero versus Chaotic, which should be Tsubaki versus Azrael, and that's Chaotic using somebody different.
Please select your character. Azrael! Tsubaki Yayoi!
I will be streaming Losers Finals, though. I want to point that out, because that will be the 3 out of 5.
The Wheel of Fate is turning.
Alright.
Rebel 1.
Now, Chaotic is using probably one of Hero's most hated characters, but I have confidence in him. This is the conversion there, but not too big a deal. Oh, this is the conversion there again. Giving orb kind of makes him more careful of her, but unfortunately gets caught with the shocker. Chaotic counter itself in Tsubaki's pressure, doesn't really want to be able to. Tsubaki's pressure is definitely more scary, just more scary if your character does not have a DP at all this disposal, which is going to be a good title for grab, but most other DPs. Good punish, but fails to meet it. Oh, the overdrive, but does not get a combo off of it. Oh, that'll be it. Oh, not quite. That pixel of health.
Rebel 2, action!
I can't see. Sorry, my vision is back a little bit. Chaotic, again, dropping his combo. Zero counter is also rather that dangerous from this situation. And Azrael gets hit by the cross. Oh, into Azrael. Zero what? Chaotic.
Please select your character.
Trying not to show my bias here, obviously I'm a little biased, but...
Tsubaki Yayoi. your sins. The wheel of fate is turning. Rebels, one. Action.
Can deal all that with that. Zero being very cautious with his approach right now, trying to get those charges in. With charges, Tsubaki can really hurt, so you be careful. Good aerial conversion getting the knockdown. But Gaddis trying to barrier him out as best he can, doesn't want to get hit. Does not want to deal with Tsubaki's initial for even a moment. That purple grab special, I'm gonna call it the chaotic special. Oh, that does not reach a bad distance. Looks like they're getting a little frazzled.
Rebel 2, action!
Good DP, sets the pressure in his favor. Gets the overhead. Oh, but dropped the combo. That could have been really nice for putting it in the corner. Good work. Oh, blocked the overhead that time. Oh, another overhead. Being very careful, probably should have punished that growler. First growl, she's not in a good drag. Spicy comment gets into the pressure. Starting to really get on chaotic, really get into chaotic cutting team, but they're kind of both getting to each other's head. One's more nerve-based. Oh, the purple grab again! The chaotic special leads into the win, 0-2 chaotic. I fought Zero many times. I think he was definitely nervous in that match. But it is what it is. Gotta get over those tournament nerves. I know firsthand what that can do to you. And yes, that is a good piece of advice to all of you. Neutral teching is your friend. Okay, so, yes, I need Ping and Stingray. Stingray, I know you're watching the stream, or if someone can, somebody can contact him. Oh, there he is. Ping, I know, plays Lychee. Ooh, do be careful.
Please select your character.
You can lay out on it if you want. I'm probably gonna answer. So. Oh, you okay?
Why would you?
I'm probably just gonna answer that.
What?
So my legs don't get all crampy. Yes, it's pain. Someone who's in the room with me got to be a tower, my bad. Because I still need to get rid of them. I can imagine this is a very difficult matchup for Bullet. Lychee outranging him every way. Good mix-up, good pressure, and oh yeah, Bullet has a rather crappy DP. But hey, it's at least something, right?
Please
But that crappy DB works out for him, but drops the combo again. Seems to be a trend for Stingray, and that might have caused him this. Yep. Super finish.
Distortion finish. Lighty. Rebel 2. Action.
So I'm just trying to get it in touch with everybody. Losers is not really progressing right now. We need it to. So that should be the damn with the drop. But managing to pull it out anyway. That return conversion. Going for staff, OP. But Stingray flashes carefully until he gets hit by the overhead. Gets fully carried into the corner. Uses King using return to keep him there, but then he switches it. Be nicer. I think I'm doing rather nice with my commentary. I don't think I'm really downing anybody. I can pretend to slap you off stream. Just don't throw it on my computer, please. If you want to land on the bed, you can just take it and put it on my channel right there if you want. I just need to keep my computer up for challenge scores. 1-0. Ping's favor. Match it to
your character.
You want to put your computer on my laptop, okay? No, I need to move it anyway. I'll move it to you over here. I don't care if it gets on my bed. Oh, that's not your green tea. There you go. After all, trying to get you your match, if you're still on the stream, trying to get Kuma to fight you.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1, action.
Well, King's bashing all over the place, trying to be careful about the bounce start. Possibly towards trying to bait him into that corner situation. Oh! May have extended that combo a little too far. Being attempted to break it in the corner, but unfortunately did not work out for him, and now he's back in the corner again. Oh, match is out of the EIQ. Nice match. Seems to be on point with things today, messing with his match out. Up. Is it back in Berkeley yet? Yep. Match 1. Pink. Back off with the staff return. Probably trying to bait the BP out. Hey, Stingray acting a little more reckless than usual seems to be proving to be as I'm doing. First stop, but will he still get it? Oh, nice DP. That didn't seal a whole lot. 50 meter though. Oh, does not dash up for the punish on that one. It's hard to do, but you definitely can do it. And that is mad for pain. He needs Axel. Oh my. Two-zero ping. Okay, I need someone who died. And Thane, though you're already in the room, so this is easy. Let's get Thane.
Please select your character.
I don't think anybody really got hyped because of that Astral. Seems to not have gone over particularly well. And you guys, there's only one more match after this one until Winners Finals, but Losers is kind of progressing slowly. So, no, Someone Who Died, that's the name of the person who's up right now. Losers is kind of progressing slowly. Oh, Someone Who Died, going for his name and me. I keep not finishing my freaking statement. Losers progresses, and it hasn't finished up, and we get to, Winners Finals, can we complete Winners Finals? I'll have to just stream Losers for a bit till we get to Grand Finals. Now, Niu is just a little on the OP side in this one. Oh, does not actually base boost. That was a nice try on the base though. They land on the peasant, abusing the lack of defensive options that he has. Some of the guys kind of having some issues dealing with that pressure. Tries to jump out, gets hit, that'll be it. A very convincing first win by Thane. Oh, keep going for that good day. Get the loot. Even though it looks like that would have been a really easy thing to drop, but Thane on point with his combos. Some of the guy now I need to get into that point of situation with first out. Perhaps he'll be able to zone him out well. Oh, he switched to the other side to put him in the corner. Oh, drops the combo. Wants back away. I think he's trying to be the reverse, but being back away a little too hard, we'll see. Both characters, or both, I was gonna say both people are playing cautiously until they did that reversal. And this is where it gets scary when you're in the orange zone against Niu, because all of Niu's team is now Niu's chip, because they somehow thought that was a terrific idea. I did contact Zero. I don't know why he's not really, I don't know why he's not getting maxed out. Oh! Nice! Nice win by Thane. Score 0-1, Thane. Alright, and
please select your character. Yuki 213.
退屈させんなよ。
That is Chan. Pain these nerves. Okay. Wait, same weapon like arguably the worst character in the game, and he just has the potential to take this whole thing. Give him some credit. He's taking a character that's usually just a scrub killer and is doing incredibly well. Staying right on someone who dies leading around those drive moves. Hi, Pain. That'll be it. Pain decisive again. Same to wrecking shit. Honestly, I don't know a ton about Fame. My pick going into it was actually someone who died here, because I thought he was in, but this is a very interesting turn about. Someone who died being, it looks like he's being a tad less aggressive, being a little more reactionary to Fame, so let's see if that works out for him. Oh, rolls out nice, actually. You know, you can get a little bit of it. You can roll out if you have the right lead. But always be careful because there's a lot of ways to catch that. Someone who died looking to turn this around, but last time Fame managed to get a comeback, so we'll see how this goes. Working on trying to trick him out. Doesn't have much barrier left and low on health. Oh! Did that be the convert to turn it around? Catch, it was a nice catch of the roll, but that might be too much in the way of shit. Yep. Way too much. It basically turns into a Mortal Kombat situation when you're out of barrier and you start having to block and you drive the attack. First out of that. Never count Fame out, but somebody's guy doing a very good job of zoning him the fuck out. Getting those combos. Oh, that mixed up. See, I forget the name of the exact move, but I know he can faint it. And that's perfect from someone who died. Everybody's calling everybody out in the chat, so it's a feisty chat.
Please select your character.
East Coast is better. I don't care if you want to call that best coast. This is another very exciting match thus far. We'll see when this match is done, I'd love to hear whether you guys think that this was more hype, or whether the Dusty Fame match was more hype. I have no idea what the history between Fame and someone who died is.
The Wheel of Fate
East Coast is awesome.
Rebel 1, action!
Oh, face the burst! That's gonna hurt. Again, damn it, not necessarily something you needed in this version. What is it? You didn't need more from the best. Or any. Oh, another person from someone who died. Fame just having a lot of issues handling him right now.
New 13 wins. Rebel 2, action.
everybody in losers, I would definitely pair the two of these guys because someone's about to enter. Match point. Someone who died. Same. Very nicely going right under that drive attack. I believe Karami's dash animation does suck him down a little bit, so he can avoid certain attacks like that easily from other characters. But same is not, or I mean, unlimited is not around, really allowed in my room, so I don't know how he could do that. Using the sticker to get the corner carry, and nice damage. SMP and still manages to get some OP, but same with that nice super to get him out of the corner and do some damage while he's at it, and switch back. All good. Up, nice stagger pressure, up. Oh shit! We are on match point with for both.
Rebel 3, action!
Double match point. Now if Fane can get him in the corner, he might be able to get it. Will this be a perfect something? Probably not, because elbow chip. Even if he bursts away, it makes it hard to get a perfect net. Oh, that's a Xeon thing. But maybe he was going for super missing put? Oh, but good pick Xeon that part. That's it. Fang takes it. Very nice work. I'm going to stand for a bit. Alrighty, Chaotic and Ping, you are up. 1-2, great, great play by Fame. Shitty matchup with a shitty character, but puts it, makes it through anyway. Again, anybody who is playing in losers, I need you guys to start reporting. I'm pretty sure some of you have completed your matchup. Completed your matches, and I just need the report.
Lighty failing.
Oh. Does that actually mean that much? You want a pillow to stand your head behind it so you're not pushing into a hard desk?
The wheel of fate is turning! Rebel 1!
Why, Chase? Versus Azrael. Another matchup, right? Imagine might be held for granted. If anybody has gotten the feeling that I don't particularly like Raichu, you're right! Matchup is crap. We'll see if Chaotic's kind of online-y sort of play works this time. Not so far. Oh, nice block by Pink. Managed to get out of the corner. Oh, clutch trigger gets through. Pink is throwing very hard when you think about it, but still managed to get decent damage off of it. Oh, I just need to reload the page. Okay. Why does losers not show up automatically? I don't get that. Oh, everybody has been reporting. Thank you. I don't get what that is. Shout out to your weird sometimes. That's 6368 is very tricky sometimes. Definitely have to get used to him if I would like to though. Oh, will that be it? Is he gonna go for the... Oh, he's not gonna go for the special. One more. Sorry guys, this is a lot of work on this season. Boys is getting a little sassy. You're good. The rather of him is a little much. Oh, and the Kappa kicked him. A rather unexpected win from Chaotic. 0-1 Chaotic. Was that bitchy? Oh my. You butt ass monkeys? Is that supposed to be ass monkeys? It's censored on my end!
Please select your character.
Oh, someone who died. If I know you, it'll take you all of... Oh yeah, the map you already played to get back into the swing. Very interesting to see that huge difference in lobby matches played. I'm guessing that Chaotic does a lot of offline and or lobby stuff. I'm guessing not ranked, because if somebody can actually find consistent matches on ranked, I would be surprised. This is not Mortal Kombat or Street Fighter.
The wheel of fate is turning.
All right, time for the comeback. We get picked kind of early, dragging into the corner. Ariel does have very good corner play, but paying that wine goes to it. Nice growler on the part of Chaotic, doesn't want to be able to return. Through the trade, we're sure if I look at anyone's save in particular. I guess paying since it's put him in the corner. King definitely playing the distance game a little more than before. Nice jumping by Chaotic leading to this corner carry. And the weak point, of course, is always scary. Oh, face the reversal! That should be it for that round. Match point, Chaotic.
Rebel 2! Action!
First he into the corner, but he blocks, gets the mash out. It's gonna be a perfect on the part of things, or am I speaking way too soon? Most times I say that I speak too soon. I'm sorry if I do you ping. Didn't mean to. Oh, the throw. Ouch. Oh, I think it was a misinfo. Or he was trying to go for the first base. Either way. Very simple confirm, but work. We'll definitely make sure he stays in that corner. Ooh, that's the overhead. King, I think, getting a little worried, but pulls it out anyway, catches his roll out with 6A.
Rebel 3, action!
Like he doesn't need charges, though. The only character who requires a charge as part of the mechanic is, like, Ori Tsubaki. Everybody else either works on a refillable stock system or one like Bang where it just goes away. And then you get a solo to run out. In a very decisive final round, 0-2 chaotic. That brings us to winner's finals. Sends Ping to losers. What the fuck? Okay, now we need Chaotic versus Fame. I keep trying to call him Sandbag because that's what he's got first before the parentheses. And Ping and Dusty can have their match. So Fame, Chaotic, I know you're both in the room and you're up. Fame just needing to take him off of, or Fame just needing things. Oh, thank you, there we go.
Please select your character.
Yes.
Yeah,
my room is hot.
Action.
A chaotic is the same. Now, chaotic killing has some surprising ones, but they even rather dominate with their agent getting someone to die. To be kind of loser. Maybe I had the wrong impression. Chaotic is not just Nephi Heavy. He's just a purple thrower, man. West Coast Battle Royale loser, let go. Oh, those big saves. I'm gonna call those the same time, but because he's the only Jeremy on Nephi that I've seen do this. Oh, good rapid. Keeping the pressure. Ooh, and the dagger pressure. Kind of screwing with Chaotic, but Chaotic was very nice to him. Gets thrown in there. Round one goes to Fame.
Rebel 2, action!
Then just dragging to the corner, chasing all of his backwards. Back rolls! He said he would've got his dagger, he's having his more chance. Oh, doesn't get his wake up. Both players playing very cautiously, rapid to avoid a punish, and keep pressure. Oh, very nice. One of the most dangerous parts about this dash is its ability to drop the up. The next player. Makes me wonder why even though Last Night already had it and Mesa had it, why they couldn't give Arvio a player color, because so far as play color goes, he's missing it to the most similar together and go together. Yes, it's gonna be archived. Nice back up to a bugger throw. Looks like he can't get out of the corner yet. Falco throw again. That is the first time that Sarah seems to be his number one pop in doing this one. Good matchup. Jeez. Bad, bad thing to do. I have him on auto-archive, so anybody wants to go back. I might post this on YouTube, I'm not sure. I would have to post it in parts, obviously, or I'd post select matches. Not really sure how I want to do this. I'll probably post it in parts. I'll try and put it in 15-minute increments, which is gonna take a while. But it is what it is. It's gonna be quite a few parts if I do upload it to YouTube. Chaotic switching to Kagura. I remember in the chat him saying he plays him. I'm not sure who his name is though. I want to say Azrael. Could be wrong.
The Wheel of Fate is turning. Rebel 1, action!
Good thing though, that lead. Where's the wise? You're up against Flame, like, don't jump. You're just asking for it at this point. Also, this is Winner's Finals. I almost forgot. This is Winner's Finals. It is 3 out of 5. Dropped the loop, actually, that time. But no biggie. Still riding on a huge health lead. Very cautious. Ooh, nice punish, just out of range of that move. Now Kagura does have scary mix-up, so he might be able to turn this around, but ooh, drop the combo. Then he seems to be overly concerned about getting hit with certain things. Oh, missed the fatal too. And JD for the win.
Rebel 2,
action! Other command gap, we don't see Phantom do that very much, but it's great as an occasional mix-up. Very, very obvious otherwise. Oh, first fatal count. Now, Mo doesn't get punished for that first throw, but at least he got the corner carry off of the mix-up. Ooh, purple throwing. Not working against him. The chaotic special is purple throwing. Although that was out of combo, so maybe I shouldn't call it a choke. One more mix-up. Well, I'm gonna call it mix-up from Sammy. One more. Yeah, I guess we'll call it mix-up for this. I don't know if Cammy really has that. Audrey, if Audrey joins, you'll definitely... I would say talk to Audrey, great. He has a really good Noel. Audrey is who I fought before. I haven't fought Lith, but I fought Audrey. He's got a pretty good Noel. 3 out of 5, people. Hopefully they know this, because they're up for the third time.
Please select your character.
Okay.
Yuki Terumi.
Yep, it's Winner's Finals, 3 out of 5. Please don't forget that. That is usual. That is the usual tournament protocol. It is 2 out of 3 until Winner's and Loser's Finals. Winner's and Loser's Finals are generally 3 out of 5. And then Grand Finals as well, 3 out of 5. Two sets to have to be won by the person coming from losers. Going back to Azuro, he did have a little bit more success with Azuro. No.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel 1, action!
Got a little more success with Azuro, so we'll see how this one goes. Although he has some bad lift by time, we'll see if he took his remedy with that. Nice back dash. Same, definitely playing the cautious game, charging in, kind of going back. Both players really being cautious right now. Good stagger pressure by Same. The stagger pressure seems to be working out pretty well against Chaotic. That finishing combo, that super, adds on a lot of damage. I don't like Unlimited Rachel at all. Like, every relationship is so fun, but if you're at all used to the newer Rachel, Unlimited Rachel plays more like the older Rachel, and I forgot that. So far as combos and stuff goes, I think 5DC causes a spin effect, which it hasn't done in Shield 1. So, I'm not really the biggest fan. Dude, the cross is very nice. Chaotic battling back.
Rebel 3, action!
Gotta make this corner count because Fame is still on that point. That will bring him into Grand Finals. Otherwise, Chaotic is definitely moving to battle. So that's okay. I don't know, considering who you tried to use, I don't think that Rachel is a good fit for people who are more of a Noelle mentality. But that's okay. Up, the stagger pressure gets Chaotic again, but he cannot convert for very much of that meter. However, that was a really, really bad forward roll, and I think that's gonna be it. Yep. 0-3. Same. The forward tech, he probably could have pulled it out, but the forward tech just did him in. Whoops, almost did that in reverse order. Okay, we are going to wait. I'm not going to do Grand Finals, obviously, since I can't. And I'm going to go through... That is, winners. I have to go through Losers Finals first. So for right now, Fame, you don't need to be here, or you can, of course, you can put yourself in Autopat. I need someone who died in Dusty, unless they're... We are just on the losers right now. We are going to do the last couple for those on stream. And, of course, giving this little exposition just in case I have to upload this in parts, and this ends up being, people don't really know if that's losers or winners. Ultra, definitely focus on Noelle and only Noelle. If you're just, you seem to be just starting out, which is fine, all well and good. And I do encourage you to enter my future tournaments, even though you're just starting out, it's a great experience. Definitely stick to Noelle. If you don't have a handle on her, I wouldn't pick up a sub at all. And with the exception of Celica, everyone you mentioned is harder to use than Noelle as well. So, do bear that in mind.
Please select your character.
You are a terrible person, Rebellion. You're just awful for that. Okay, so we're gonna have... I have no idea who... Is it gonna go Kokonoe? It's gonna go with Kokonoe this time. We're gonna have someone who died. You want your tea? Someone who died versus Dusty. Huh? Now, this is not Loser's Final, so right now we're still 2 out of 3. I want to say his primary sub is Kokonoe. I could be wrong, though.
Kokonoe.
The wheel
of fate is turning. Rebel 1.
Remember, guys, this is not Loser's Finals, but we are Loser's Battle right now.
Very
nice helper. Ah, the fatal, but nothing too good. I think gravity kind of screwed with him on that one. Oh, nice bait. But, of course, that fireball still lingers. Dusty, jump to avoid that mix-up. Oh! Recovered from the anti-air fast enough to not just punish the fact that it counters it. Nice use of Ignis to get in, but could not capitalize on it. Oh, good throw break. Knew he was trying to do that to get rid of his fireball. Probably wouldn't, well, not get rid of it, but he wouldn't get split with that. If it was a successful throw.
Rebel 2, action!
Good counter hit. Gonna leave the corner here now that he has to go very far. Oh, does not go for the unblockable. Well, he did. I think he was gonna go for the unblockable. Recognize that someone who died was not going to attack him instead by taking damage. Good non-tag on someone who died by fear boy to be set from the unblockable. Overdrive raid. Really good one too, since this might turn everything around. Zoning Dusty out right now until he got into the corner. Now just delay on his pressure. Nice block. Gets the fatal. No fatal conversion again. Dusty is out of there. Oh, nice cross up teleport with the trap. 1-0, someone who died. Cross up teleport with that trap out, definitely one of Kokonoe's more dangerous tactics. Are we calling lag?
Please select your character.
Are you calling lag is the reason here?
Relius Clover. Coco Noe.
Coco Noe. Just the way the announcer says that. We are trying to blame lag a little bit here. The salt is real. Ah, so like a theme. Definitely one of the better themes. I wasn't a fan of some of the newer themes for the characters, both the two versions of new characters' themes, but I gotta just tell you it's done very nicely.
Rebel 1!
That's his kind of battle box. Get someone who died. Now remember, you guys, this is losers, i.e. whoever does win, it doesn't get sent away, they're out. So the pressure is definitely on for both players, especially since they're so close to the end of the tournament. Somebody that doesn't get out of the corner this time. Really decisive first round. Bye, Dusty.
Rebel 2! Action!
Oh! Very nice catch! But the bird got somebody that at the corner advantage. Gotta be prepared to block for long times against Token Eye. Unfortunately, Dusty seems to be playing a little on the defensive side. So probably better than I could too, though. I can block patiently for a while, and I'm actually decent at blocking, but I don't know about the blocking button that Dusty has. Ooh, dropped the combo, but managed to get to me anyway. Oh, great backdash there. Great convert. That'll be it. 1-1. Dusty. Taking that one. So this will kind of determine if who I initially thought after I saw what the brackets were is going to move ahead. When I initially saw the brackets again, someone who died was the one I thought would end up making it all the way to the end, being declared winner. But it looks like it might not be that way. But we'll see. He could still battle back.
Please select your character.
There are some very strong players in this tournament. Some great hype matches going on. Dusty has a very good Relius. An RC or a CA? Depends on what time you're talking about. She used to farm a few times.
The Wheel of Fate is turning! Rebel 1! Action!
At least it's not like... Oh, nice touch bait! That's gonna hurt. Ooh, very good with the no-tech to avoid it, and low power corner gets caught anyway, though. Row counter. This is gonna be a perfect. Dusty abusing the fact that he knows someone who died is going to expect the unblockable setup and is not teching therefore, getting some guaranteed damage from this. Well, not guaranteed that he detected that little thing in the guarantee, but still. Pretty good. Ooh, nice. Definitely thought he'd be kind of put up to get the catch, even if covered him. Did not catch the rollout.
Please
SMT on that. Oh, bait the bird. But not bird. Reverse will be bird. Stay on the first. This goes to show you when things are baiting. It hurts a lot, especially bird. So anybody who thinks bird can get a jail free card, these two players will show you exactly why that's not the case. First thing is just as risky as it is beneficial upon successful landing. To 5-6? That would not be a command. You need 2-1-6. You need 2-3-6? Guess he's gonna die in the corner. Do me 2-3-6. Oh, that's it. Decisively by someone who died. 1-2, that does knock Dusty out of the tournament. That Kokonoe corner pressure is a beast. It looks like someone who died might get his run back. Unless Chaotic takes him out of the tournament. Okay, different. No, I don't think he's... No, Dusty wasn't his first opponent. Fame was. He still needs to... Someone who died still needs to be Chaotic 3 times in order to have that run back against Fame. But right now, it's just Fame. Ultra, you need to study notations, otherwise we're not gonna know what you're talking about. Notations, terminology, very important. If someone could tell... Well, I'll get it in there. Oh, he knows. Okay. Okay, now we are in Loser's Finals, so again, 3 out of 5.
Please select your character.
You know, Chaotic, you say that, but you've been doing very well. Oh, is he gonna, show ping up here? Is he gonna try and show ping up here? He can't avenge Dusty if he doesn't make the pass Chaotic. Or if someone who died doesn't make the pass Chaotic is what I mean. Is that the Galileo color? I think it is. So remember Galileo color? Our Evo 2K14 winner for anybody who watched that. It might not be right. No wait, no it's not. Is that his color? If it's not, it's something very similar to that. Now Ping did lose this one. So if someone who dies right before it, that'll be very interesting. Although, of course, loser always has the opportunity to switch. That should be noted for anybody who's not familiar with usual tournament rules. So now there are some people in the chat who are not. So far as tournament rules go, generally speaking, winners are not able to switch their character, but losers are. Got a kind of bursting out of that, hoping to get a run back to avoid a huge health deficit, never count somebody out. Oh, bad counter attack. But he will work out for him anyway. Although the return, yep, that's it.
Lychee,
win!
Rebel 3, action!
You can't Oh my god, just chasing him down. It's gonna be a perfect good counter attack. Barrier's down very far though. He needs to stop going to aerial with that barrier. Ooh, perfect. Someone who died. Remember, when you don't have barrier, you cannot block in the air. Turns into Street Fighter, KOF, any other game where you cannot block in the air. If you want.
Please select your character. Lychee Bailey. Azrael.
Something like that. Oh, he doesn't have a choice. But I'm saying he's gonna stick with Lychee, but then I realize he doesn't have a choice. After I just explained that. It's funny, this one is actually lasting longer than my other tournament, but I had a lot more entrants, and I know it wasn't just the stream, so it's very interesting.
The Wheel of Fate is turning.
My Guilty Gear tournament ended around this time, a few minutes after. It's lasting a little longer. Then I got a few matches that are a lot closer. Did not expect him to be able to block that, but Return has very good recovery on it, so I guess I should have. Gets hit by the back kick. Ooh, the last leg. That might have worked out poorly for Chaotic. Looks like it did. Ooh, bad mash out. Gets hit does not need a favor. Chaotic being very cautious about attempting Growler on the staff return, I think he's got to hit a lot for time. Kind of felt like brings him to the corner. Oh, good anti air. Oh, the DP though.
Rebel 2, action!
Ooh, he tried to kind of get through that pressure, almost had it, but not quite. Like, he kind of barely beat him out there. Good corner drag. Carry, I mean. Not sure if that was the first play, I think so, though. Oh, perhaps back that one too many times. Probably should have kept that the one backdash. Does anybody know how to really combo into her after? What? Okay, didn't expect that. That magical pixel. You seem really hot, are you okay? When did you go get an ice pop? That'll probably cool you down. They've gotta be at this point. Drop the micro dash.
Please select your character.
Oh, days ago.
Ragnar the Blood Edge. Lychee Bailey.
No, I didn't have food. I had just a soda. Yeah. That was really bothering me. Very hot.
Oh,
decides to switch to Ragna this time. Could be a risky decision, might pay off though.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel one. Action.
This is chaotic. Last chance to battle, to start battling back. Oh, there's no last chance thing. A few more matches. The BBCPEX now. That Evo was it, what was that? Evo 2K13? Was that the collusion game? Or was it 14? I wanna say it was 14. I remember that. I thought that collusion story was everywhere. Couldn't escape it. If you guys are fighting him first at all. I think the story even makes shitty sites like Kotaku. Match point, someone who died.
Rebel 2, action!
Lightsy worked out very well for him. He sounds like everybody. So I'm not surprised that he's using Lightsy, but why would I go with me for this? And Chaotic is really struggling to get through Lightsy's turn. Although oddly, if memory serves, the matchup actually considers food traditionally in Latin favor due to its strong position and how they are faster than Lightsy Bison. But Samurai Jack doesn't really care about that. That's it. Very, very decisive 3-0, someone who died. And that finally brings us to Grand Finals, and yes, someone who died might get his run back, we'll see. Whoops, I forgot to report that. Give me 1 minute, I forgot to report the previous match. Okay, we are at Grand Finals. Now, everybody, remember, someone who died has to win 2 sets in order to win the tournament. While Fame only has to win 1, so it's gonna be a difficult run back on someone who died's part. Lost the first time, and has to win double this time. How that works, for those who are unaware, when the person who's coming from losers wins against the person who's coming from winners, it resets the bracket by putting the person in losers, or by putting the person who was in winners, by the way, that means they hadn't touched losers yet, puts them down to losers, and then basically, since there's no one else for them to fight in losers, they just automatically fight the person they just fought. Alright, and we're waiting. Someone who died has to be given a second. Alrighty, goodbye, Chaotic. BRB again? Okay, this could take a minute, you guys. That's okay though. We're about done anyway. At most, we've 6 matches to go. It's been a really, really good tournament. Once again, a thank you to everybody who watched. Thank you to everybody who participated, win, lose, otherwise. If you didn't like your performance and you want to review it, of course. And I actually say this to anybody, who, even if you're okay with your performance, if you ended up in losers, if you didn't win this tournament, you might want to go back and say, you know. You might want to go back and say, hey, here's what I did wrong by watching your match. Very important as a player to know what your weaknesses are. Ask around. Watch some of your matches after you're done with your matches. Contemplate as soon as you're done what you could have done better. They all help you become a better player. Now, I'm not a tournament winner. Well, I'm not bad. So, I think I have, you know, I think that's worth taking my advice, right? That works? By Take Mikazuchi as Rachel. Who's... What character are you referring to with Take Mikazuchi? Are you referring to Hazuma? Or Terumi? If you want to see bits of my Rachel play, you can always go to my YouTube channel. I do have a few matches up from her. I'm usually very critical of my BlazBlue play, as it's one of my main tournament games, so I don't upload a ton for that one. But, oh, Highlander Assault, okay. Oh, you want me to do an offline mode? I don't know if I even touched that mode. Oh, yes I did. I take that back. Maybe some other time, not tonight. We'll see. A couple times I've streamed me doing some offline stuff with this. Other things that you'll see on my Twitch channel in addition to fighting games. I do play Smite, although I don't take it competitive. I don't take it too seriously. So, you won't see me getting into the competitiveness of it. I'm a competitive person, so some of that comes out. Until SWD gives me notice that he has to drop, he didn't say he had to. No. Did he say he had to? Does that really finish things? Oh, I'm gonna check Discord. I don't see that. Where did he post that? PSN Netplay? In the stream trap? Did anybody else see that? I can't scroll up on the PS4. Can somebody scroll up and confirm what Chaotic is saying? Because someone who died didn't leave the room. I could have sworn he said that his dad was yelling at him, but I don't remember him saying he had to drop, unless I just missed the message. There have been 500 messages. Oh, okay. Well, that's it, I guess. Okay, I didn't see. Hey, there's a lot of messages here. There's 506 total as of that last message. Alrighty, well, congratulations to Bane, I guess. Kind of anticlimactic end there. So, there was no run back, but still, great job to both players, even though someone who died had to drop. Would have been interesting to see if he could have gotten the run back. But I will change that appropriately. Congratulations, Fame. You doth win the tournament. Yes, good games to everybody. Thank you so much for participating. I'm not going to use that. I have to piss like a racehorse. At some point, I will. I'm not gonna fight him, and I'm not gonna fight him on stream, either. Not because I'm afraid of what you guys will see, but because I am the person streaming. I'm not going to try and fuck with our connection, especially when we're playing Coast to Coast on a stream. I'm sure if Fame wants to fight me, or if I want to fight Fame, we'll get in touch with one another at some point, and we'll probably fight offline. If you guys want, I can probably record our replays, and we'll see. But thank you so much, everybody, and you're very welcome to anybody, to the people who thank me. I love doing this. This is my second time playing host to the tournament. I'll be doing something weekly. It'll likely be ASW heavy, but it'll be a different fighting each week. Next week, I'm thinking either Street Fighter V or Mortal Kombat. For anybody who plays Street Fighter V, basically what I do in a lot of these cases is Ange is generally the host of these. So what I do is Ange hosts something else while I host whatever game I plan on doing for that week. My weeklies will always be held on Saturdays. Goodbye, Ultra, and you're welcome. Thank you. Thank you for your participation, your watch. Anyway, I will be hosting one this coming Saturday. However, I will not be hosting one the following Saturday, as I'll be at Summer Jam. So it will be a week break. Sorry if that disappoints anybody, but hey, I'll probably be on stream at Summer Jam. If it happened last year, I think you've got like more than a 50% chance of landing on stream if you enter in Summer Jam, I freaking swear. But I will be there, so everybody wish me luck. It's one of the biggest East Coast events, for those who are not aware. Great major. I did terribly last year, and I would love to redeem myself this year. But, one last time, thank you all of you, participants, watchers. If you want to follow me, I would appreciate it. You can follow me on here, you can follow me on my Twitter, and you can follow me on YouTube. And they all have the same name. So, no confusion. Alright, bye, guys. Bye-bye.